Aw man, this article is so long. I don't have the time to read everything. Goodbye. Aw man, this article is so long. Oh, they have a table of contents. I'm interested in this part. I'll check it out. Well, a table of contents is important for any article, especially for articles longer than 2,000 words, because it provides your site visitors with a clear and organized overview of your article, which helps them find what they are looking for easily, that inherently improves page experience, a ranking factor. Now, if you haven't been adding a table of contents to your articles, it's time for you to do so. We'll show you how. And if you have been using a separate WordPress plugin just for the table of contents, you can remove that now because RankMath has that too for you. And if you are using a table of contents block from plugins like Yoast or All-in-One SEO, we'll show you how to transform them into RankMath's table of contents block. Let's go. Hey, it's Jack from RankMath, the one WordPress SEO plugin that constantly strives to provide you with the fastest and the most cutting-edge SEO tools. And on this channel, we are constantly sharing up-to-date and accurate SEO knowledge, like clockwork. So if you haven't subscribed to us yet, consider subscribing. Anyway, let's add a table of contents on our articles, shall we? All right, now I've written this article. It is about 2,800 words long. And I intend to place a table of contents between the image and the first H2 heading tag. So let's hit enter. You can search for the table of contents block by either typing the / and table, and you should see the table of contents block by RankMath. Alternatively, you can click on add block, browse all, scroll down, and you should see RankMath's blocks here. Click on the table of contents block, and it will add a table of contents to your article. Simple and easy. You see, whatever you have added in the heading tags, for example, how does an air fryer work? How does a deep fryer work? They will be organized and displayed in this hierarchy. These are the H2 heading tags. These are the H3s, H4s, and H5. Now, what you're seeing currently is the numbered style. If you don't want the bullets to be in numbers, because maybe you have already added numbers to your headings like so, you can click to select the table of contents block and this quick edit bar will appear. You can now select the bullet option and it will look like this. And if you don't really like the indentation, you can align everything to the left like so. But personally, I like this. You can make this block wide width, full width, which takes up the entire screen. These two options will depend on the theme you use. You can align left so that your table can share space with your content. The same goes for align right. Or you can simply align it center, whichever works for you. Now to adjust the block settings, all you need to do is to click on it, make sure that the settings button is selected and the block tab is selected as well. The title wrapper is the headings, paragraph, or the div tag you want to give to this title for the table of contents. Personally, I would not have the table of contents title as one of the heading tags. I will have it as a bold paragraph. This is my personal preference, it's up to you to decide. And then, if there is a block of heading tags you wish to hide, for example, you see this H5 heading tag that is out of the norm, you can just exclude all the H5 heading tags from the table of contents and they will be gone. Next, you can change the color of the text to fit your brand. If either one of these preset colors are not suitable, just click on this and you can paste the color code of your brand here. Let's test this out. You see, this setting will change the color of the text and the bullets of the block. If you want to change the color of these links, click on the link settings and you'll be able to change the color. You can change the background color as well. If you want to have a table of contents like we do on our blog, what you can do is to select the gradient option. You can choose either one of these presets. You can add gradient points so that you can alter the gradient. And if you don't want that, you can just remove the control point. But if we want to customize it to be like this, all we need to do is to click on this control point that controls the color on the left. Let's change it to this color code. And on the other control point that controls the color on the right, I'll change the color code to this. And then, referring to our block, the angle of the purple is from downwards up. So let's adjust the angle to 60 degrees. And now it looks like what we have on our block. just that we need to change the text color to white, the links to white as well, and there. That's how you customize the design of your table of contents. For the typography, you can change the line height by clicking on these three vertical dots and line height. You will see the settings here. As you adjust the settings, you can see the spaces between the lines expanding or contracting. You can change the size of the text to these predefined settings, small, medium, large, etc. And if there is a specific size you want, you can click on this. Select the measurement you are comfortable with. For me, I'll usually use the pixels, and I'll add the specific size. And then, you can adjust the spacing around the table of contents block by expanding the dimensions, and you will see the padding and margin settings. For padding, it is to control the spaces between the border and the actual content of your block. If you increase the padding, the actual content will be pushed in, and if it is at zero, it means your content will be near the border of the block. As for the margin, it is controlling the spaces outside of the block. If you add the margin, the entire block will be squeezed in. So the padding controls the spaces inside the block, and the margin controls the spaces outside the block. So feel free to play with this. And finally, if you can't get the design you want from the settings we have here, or your theme is adding extra spaces around the table of contents title or under the links, then your best option is to add your own CSS classes. The CSS target will be this. Now, did you notice that as I hover to the table of contents item, you see these buttons here? These buttons will allow you to change the anchor link or hide the item. Let's talk about this first. For example, if I don't want to display one of the H3 heading tags, for example this, that comes together with the H4s relating to it, click on the I for that item, and the entire section will be hidden from the table of contents. And if you don't want, for example, just this to be displayed on the table of contents, just click on hide, and it will be hidden. So this is very helpful if you want to hide items individually. Also, if you want to change the text of the item in case the title is too long, for example this, you can simply change the text without amending the actual title. Now, basically, these links from the table of contents are jump links. In other words, anchor links. So even without this table of contents block, you can still create a table of contents using anchor links and the list block. So to better explain this jump link, in case you don't know what it is, let me show you an example. Let's add a list block for this block of text. You see each of these lists is reflecting the headings. So I'll go to the first H2 heading, and then I'll expand the advanced settings, and this is the HTML anchor. Let's say that if I add GVD, which represents the short form of grills versus deep fryers, you're gonna make sure that the words or letters are linked, either with dashes, underscores, or just remove the spaces. Like so. Let's copy this, go to the list, highlight the text, click on this to add a link. You want to put a hashtag followed by the text you have added to the HTML anchor and save it. As you update this page, view post. So as you click on this, it will lead you to the section. It works just like the table of contents block. And this is what jump link is. But if you do this, it takes a lot of time, and that's why the table of contents block makes things convenient for you. Let's remove this list. If you have customized the HTML anchor, when you add the table of contents block, we will not amend that anchor. But for those headings you did not customize, we will automatically add an anchor for you. But if you don't like the auto anchor links we have added for you, maybe if it is too long, you can customize them by clicking on this edit link, and you can change it. Just make sure that you change the HTML anchor as well. Otherwise, that customized link will not work. So as we update this, refresh the page. As I click on this customized link, it will bring me to that section. What do you think of the table of contents block? Are you liking what you see? If yes, can you support us with a thumbs up? And if you have any suggestions for improvements, do leave them in the comments as well. Now, let's talk about how to reuse the table of contents block. All right, we like everything about the design of this table of contents block, and you wish to use it on all your other articles as well. We are pretty sure you don't want to redesign this block over and over again, so how should you reuse this block? Well, turn this block into a reusable block. Click on the block, expand the options, and create a reusable block. Give it a name, say, default table of contents, and save. Next, go to another article where you want to add the table of contents. Let's say I want to add the table of contents block here. Let's hit enter, click on add block, browse all, and over here you'll see the reusable tab. Click on that, and here's the reusable block we have just added. Click on that, and the table of contents block will reflect all the topics and subtopics related to this article. On top of that, even though this is a reusable block, any changes you make to this block will not affect the other blocks that are using the reusable block. Like if you change the color of the links to yellow, and let's save changes. If you visit the other pages that use the same reusable block, it would not be affected. So that's how you can reuse the table of contents block. Now, let's visit the global settings. Now, to change the default settings of a table of contents block, go to RankMath's general settings, click on blocks, and you can change the default title for the block. Let's say that I change it to read more. Let's save changes. So the next time you add a table of contents block, the title will reflect what you've added on the global settings. And then you can change the list style of the block to numbered or unordered, which are the bullets. And you can choose to exclude certain heading tags by default. All right. That's how you can add and customize the table of contents block by RankMath. But what if you have used table of contents block from other plugins like Yoast and All-in-One SEO? If you decide to migrate to RankMath, wouldn't the table of contents be messed up? Let's talk about that now. Now, if you're migrating from All-in-One SEO or Yoast to RankMath for the first time, when you go through the setup wizard, the information will be imported to RankMath's table of contents block. So you don't have to do anything extra and the blocks will display normally. Now, if you realize that the table of contents block from the other plugins are not displaying properly after you have migrated to RankMath, which shouldn't be the case, but if it does, then all you need to do is to head over to RankMath status and tools, select the database tools, and you will see the Yoast block converter. If you use All-in-One SEO, then you will see this instead. RankMath will detect and display accordingly. Click on this convert blocks, and the blocks will automatically be converted to RankMath's table of content blocks. So, we really hope to have added one new tool to your SEO toolbox and maybe reduce one single use table of content plugin for you. If you have any questions, suggestions, or feedback about our table of contents block, do let us know in the comments. And if it's anything technical, feel free to contact our friendly support team. We are always here to help. Anyway, smash that thumbs up button if you find this video helpful. Subscribe to us for the most accurate and up-to-date SEO knowledge. This is Jack from RankMath. Stay awesome, and I'll see you in the next video.